So here we are another day here at the zoo without any public. And we're in the Galapagos tortoise exhibit. This is Goliath, the Galapagos tortoise. This is the largest living land tortoise on Earth. These guys can get to be over 500 pounds. He actually weighs 525 pounds. You notice how he's standing up real still as I scratch his neck? There's a reason for this. In the Galapagos Islands, these animals get ticks. And there's a bird, a type of finch, that eats the ticks. So when they feel something here, like my hand, they go into an instinctive freeze frame. So the bird can fly in there and eat all the ticks. It's what we call a symbiotic relationship, where the tick gets eaten as food for the bird, and the tortoise loses a parasite. Now, these guys are also one of the longest living vertebrates on Earth. The record Galapagos tortoise lived over 170 years. They're found on different islands, and depending on the island, it tells you the shape of the shell. For instance, this is kind of a dome-shaped shell, but there are other islands that have a saddle-type shell, where the tortoise can stick his head real high to reach foods that he likes to eat. They love to eat all kinds of vegetation, particularly cactus and prickly pear cactus. Now, the cool thing about this is that tortoises have shells, and a lot of people think that a tortoise can get in and out of its shell. They watch too many cartoons. The bottom line is the shell is part of its ribs. All fused together, it grows with the animal. And actually, when the animal's young, you can count the rings on each scute to help tell you the age of the tortoise. Another interesting fact about Galapagos tortoises. They're called Galapagos because the Spanish word Galapago means saddle, which is what they thought that the back of the shell looked like, a saddle. And that's what the islands are named after. So the islands are actually named after these tortoises. They were taken off the island by the hundreds, even thousands, because they can go up to a year without food or water. So the sailors back in the 16, 1700s used them as a fresh source of meat. They put them on the ships. They didn't have to feed them. They didn't have to water them. Whenever they wanted to butcher them to eat them, it was fresh meat. Fortunately, they're coming back now. They're protected on the Galapagos Islands. These are truly kind of a living relic from the past. And a cute little side note. Anybody watch the movie E.T.? Look at his face. It's E.T. Just a little side note.